हाय फ्रेंड्स, मैं नेम इज चैतन्य पथके एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू टेक अ लुक एट द प्रीव्यू ऑफ द मैच बिटवीन अफगानिस्तान एंड बांग्लादेश विच इज गोइंग टू टेक प्लेस एट शारजा क्रिकेट स्टेडियम। इट इज़ द थर्ड मैच ऑफ द एशिया कप 2022। बाय जजिंग बाय द करंट फॉर्म, अफगानिस्तान स्टार्ट्स आर फेवरेट बिकॉज एज वी नो दैट दे कम्प्लीटली स्मोक श्रीलंका इन द ओपनर ऑफ द एशिया कप। बट यू कैन नेवर अंडर एस्टिमेट बांग्लादेश because of the amount of experience that their senior players have, as well as the amount of T20 cricket that their players play all around the world. So it will be foolish to give them a chance in this contest. But yes, Afghanistan don't start as overwhelming favorites, but they do start as favorites. First of all, I would like to tell you the probable 11 of Bangladesh which they can field. According to the pitch condition, the pitch in Sharjah is usually it is a two-paced wicket. Fast bowlers generally get a lot of help, and due to the small sizes of the boundaries, it might be assumed that the scores in Sharjah are in the range of 180 to 190 when it comes to T20 cricket. But you would be surprised to know that is certainly not the case, because there is low bounce and the wicket is two-paced. The average score is between 143 and 145, and batsmen find it very difficult. There is a scope for batsmen when the pitch is very dry and placid. Then the square boundaries certainly help, because the leg side of the Sharjah stadium is size is very limited, so that can be an advantage for batsmen, but that doesn't happen in most of the cases. So this is my Bangladesh 11, probable Bangladesh 11, which they will field again against Afghanistan. I will open with Mohammad Naeem and Anamul Haq Bijoy. That is the tried and tested combination for Bangladesh, although Anamul Haq's recent form hasn't been very good. Bangladesh management can expect him to come good. Shakib Al Hasan, the skipper, returning to the T20 international side as skipper after 3 years, so it will be a new start for him, and he has taken a break in the recent while, so it will be interesting to see how he plays. Afif Hussain, the newly appointed vice captain of Bangladesh, many cricket experts in Bangladesh as well as those who follow Bangladesh cricket closely are touting him as the next superstar, so there will be lot of expectations and pressure for him. Hopefully he can deliver. I will go in with Mushfiqur Rahim at number 4 instead of Afif Hussain can come down, because I always believe that in T20 the best batsman should face the maximum deliveries. So for me, Afif Hussain can come 3 down, because he has the talent and ability, and he has the street smart cricketer that even though the amount of balls will be less, he can make it up with his stroke play. Mehmedullah Riyaz for me will come in at number 6. Shabbir Rehman will come in at number 7. Although his form is also a bit patchy, but his hitting is beyond doubt. Mehdi Hassan will come in at number 7, the off spinner. Mohammad Saifuddin, the fast bowling all rounder, who is also capable of hitting some lusty blows towards lower down the order, and it is a vital cog in the wheel of Bangladesh. For me, he comes in the squad. It's a no-brainer. He uses his variations pretty nicely. He has a great yorker, uses slower delivery very deceptively, and is very difficult to negotiate on his day. Nasum Ahmed, the off spinner. And I will go in with the final player, the Fizz Mustafizur Rahman. As we know that his cutters and his change of pace and his yorkers are brilliant. He is a proven performer for Bangladesh over the years, as well as the T20 circuit. He plies his trade in various T20 leagues around the world, which stands him in good stead. So it will be foolish to write off Bangladesh. And coming to the Afghanistan squad, I think they don't need to make any changes. Continue with the playing 11 that hammered Sri Lanka a couple of 3 days ago. For me, Zazai and Gurbaz will open. It will be interesting to see if Bangladesh get an opening, how Ibrahim Zadran plays, because he isn't very much exposed to such pressure kind of situation. Najibullah Zadran is an experienced campaigner, we know. He's a great player. Karimullah Janat is an upcoming all-rounder in the associate nation. I wouldn't classify Afghanistan as associate nation now, but his talent is there to see, his raw talent is there to see, although he hasn't converted his potential into performance, but he will surely do that in the upcoming days. and what greater platform than Asia Cup. Mohammad Nami, the skipper, he can bowl in the power play, he can bowl in the middle overs as well, and his lusty hitting is well known throughout the world. Rashid Khan, the most important player for Afghanistan, although he didn't get a wicket in the last match, he just gave away 12 runs in 4 overs, so he did well. And it will be expected that Rashid bowls at least one over in the power play, two in the middle overs, and if needed, one over between 17 to 20. That depends on the captain. But as we know that Mohammad Nabi is a very street smart captain and a very thinking cricketer, he will surely manage his bowlers accordingly. Azmatullah Omarzai is an option for Afghanistan. Naveen Ul Haq, the slingy action, his action resembles Jasprit Bumrah a bit. He can be an option in the power play. His Yorkers are very good. Mujibur Rahman will certainly bowl in the power play. He has all sort of tricks up his sleeve. The googly, the flipper, and the normal off spinner as well. If he gets couple of wickets in the power play, then believe me, Bangladesh are in deep, deep trouble, and they have to read him from the hand. They have to read him from the hand, not off the pitch, because if you read off spinners off the pitch, then you will be in big trouble, because you get less time to negotiate the ball, and you are in big trouble already. So that are not good signs. And there is a trend currently that the Asian batsmen also don't seem to pick the spinners from the hand. They prefer to play it from the pitch. That is not a good technique to have. I'm sure Bangladesh batsmen must do their homework, otherwise they will be in trouble against Mujib, because he is a very classy bowler. He has his proven record in the IPL, BBL, PSL, in every T20 franchise of repute in the world. And my final player is the man of the match against Sri Lanka, Fazal Haq Farooqi, who has impressed one and all. Indian fans know Fazal Haq Farooqi, especially the Sunrisers Hyderabad fan. His great talent, he brings the ball in, he has a good in-swinger as well as a good out-swinger, and he pitches the ball up, which is very important for an opening bowler. And when he recognizes that there is no help in the pitch at all, he shifts his length a little back, that is a back of length, and tries to contain runs as well, although his main option is wicket taking, which he should focus and which he is doing currently very well. So I think Afghanistan, as I said at the start of the video, start as favorites, but don't let Bangladesh count out. The team winning the toss should bowl first, in my opinion, and it will be interesting to see who wins the toss and does what. So how did you like my analysis of this match? Please tell in the comment section below, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel, and press the bell icon for further notifications. We'll meet in the next video. Till then, everyone, bye.